Medical services in Hong Kong are ranked among the best in the world because of availability, affordability, and quality. The city's urban population of 7.4 million enjoys universal healthcare. That access to care is part of the reason why Hong Kong people have one of the highest life expectancies in the world, 82.2 years for men and 87.6 years for women. The local system is two-track. On one side, there is the affordable public sector. The government-funded hospital authority annually spends 68.8 billion Hong Kong dollars on its hospitals and medical institutions. That's nearly 8.8 billion US dollars. On the other side, Hong Kong also has an extensive private sector. While a public hospital only charges 120 Hong Kong dollars or 15 US dollars per night, a private hospital can charge between 500 and 45,000 Hong Kong dollars per bed. That's a range of between about 60 to nearly 6,000 US dollars. If you can't afford that, you always have the low-cost public system, but you might experience long waiting times before you can be treated. During the peak flu season in January 2019, non-urgent cases at accident and emergency departments in Hong Kong public hospitals had to wait about 8 hours. And when these patients finally see a doctor, consultations sometimes only last for a few minutes because of the lengthy queue outside. The most recent statistics show that the accident and emergency services at the city's 18 public hospitals handled nearly 2.2 million patients in the 2017-18 fiscal year. Patients can often wait for years to get treatment in cases that are not life-threatening. A person with cataracts can expect to wait more than 2 years for surgery at a hospital in Hong Kong's New Territories West area. To see an orthopedic specialist on the west side of Hong Kong Island, the waiting time for the first appointment could be up to 3 years. At the same time, the public system has a serious shortage of practitioners. Administrators estimate they need about 300 more doctors and 400 more nurses on staff. In January 2019, doctors and nurses from public hospitals held rallies to complain about their heavy workload, long work hours, and poor overtime pay. The 2019-20 government budget promised 720 million Hong Kong dollars, that's nearly 92 million US dollars, for staff retention measures. To relieve the staffing shortage, the Medical Council also approved a plan to make it easier for overseas-trained doctors to work in the city. Officials have also pursued closer integration of the private and public sectors as a way to relieve some of the stress on Hong Kong's medical infrastructure. The success of Hong Kong's medical service adds to the pressure on it. The city's expanding and aging population are the primary users of the public sector and put the most strain on their resources. Another major challenge for the public healthcare system is its relative lack of comfort and privacy. Limited space often makes public hospital wards overcrowded. Hospital wards sometimes have more beds than they are designed for, and some patients even end up in corridors. So while you're guaranteed affordable healthcare in Hong Kong, it is far from a luxurious experience. By contrast, private hospitals strictly monitor the capacity of wards. Some institutions even offer rooms with only one or two beds. The private sector handles only 10% of the patients in the city, but employs more than half of Hong Kong's 14,000 registered doctors. This exclusivity and individual care contributes to the fact that private healthcare in Hong Kong is one of the most expensive in the world. It's expensive, and the pricing is not standardized among private hospitals. Different institutions will have different prices for the same procedure. The government has ordered at least two of the city's 13 private hospitals, Gleneagles Hospital and the Medical Center of the Chinese University of Hong Kong, set to open in 2020 to enhance transparency by pricing some of their services in packages to avoid unexpected bills. With prices so high and often confusing, many people seek private medical insurance. But as in many markets around the world, health insurance in Hong Kong is neither cheap nor easy to understand. So if you need to see a doctor in Hong Kong, what do you do? Going public or private may depend on whether you have a simple runny nose or something more serious. And of course, how much money or insurance you have to pay for it all. But the good news is, you have options either way.